In June of 1992, Toby Keith blasted onto the American country music airwaves with a sexy, scintillating tale of debauchery in Hollywood, now known to history as the smash hit, Perry's a Gay Man Now.
Now, growing up, I was influenced by all the greats, Liberace, Elton John, Ricky Martin, Lady Gaga, Freddie Mercury, Lance Bass, Melissa Etheridge, Lil Nas X.
You know, Toby was just this redneck from Florida, writes this song about some gay guy out in Hollywood named Scary Fairy or something. Next thing you know, he's a superstar. Naked women lining up backstage at his show, throwing themselves at him.
Every so often, one or two of these women would ask where they could find Perry Caravello, saying they would want to have sex with him, but I would have to tell him, Perry's not interested, he's a gay man, he's a man made for men, so don't even bother.
But Toby Keith's hunger for success was matched only by his appetite for excess.
Quite often, it was a 24-hour-day party, Tupperware's full of cocaine, literally Tupperware.
First time I ever did drugs was in Perry's apartment in Reseda. He forced me to do cocaine. I remember one time I passed out after drinking absinthe. I woke up and saw him sodomizing a stuffed dog on his couch. It was degrading, demoralizing, disgusting.
But Toby Keith's hard-drinking, hard-living, tough guy way of life wasn't meant to last. Toby Keith spiraled down into a dark web of self-destruction with drugs and alcohol.
And by now, he was mixing Valiums, Prozacs, alcohol, coke, whatever anybody would give him.
On February 5th, 2024, Toby Keith suffered a fatal marijuana overdose and died at his home in Homosassa Springs, Florida. He was 69 years old.